Dear students, assalamu alaikum. Today we will discuss about aromaticity. We will discuss its four criteria which are important for a compound to become aromatic. Students, after that we will deeply study about evidence of aromaticity, and in the end we will discuss some importance of aromaticity. So dear students, kindly like, subscribe and share this channel. Let's begin the discussion. So students, let's begin the discussion. What is aromaticity? So we will discuss what is the conceptual definition about aromaticity. A ring that does have a loop of pi electron is said to be aromatic. So one of the most important criteria of a compound to be an aromatic, it must have pi electron. It means it have some sort of conjugation in it. So we will discuss deeply what are the four important criteria which are necessary for a compound to be an aromatic. So students, first criteria is compound must be cyclic. One of the most important criteria for a compound to be aromatic is that compound must be cyclic. Second important criteria, each element within a ring must have p orbital, which is perpendicular to the ring, hence the molecule is planar. So the second important idea, yeah, second important postulates regarding aromaticity is that compound or a molecule should be planar. A compound or a molecule is planar when it is sp2 hybridized. It means all the compound which has sp2 hybridization in it, they are planar. This means that the ring cannot contain a neutral sp3 carbon. All those rings which contain sp3 carbon, they are non-planar. So one of the most important concept behind aromaticity is that a compound which want to be an aromatic is that it must have planar geometry. For planar geometry, its hybridization would be sp2. So let's begin third postulate. The compound must follow Huckel rule in order to gain aromaticity. The third important criteria is that the compound must follow Huckel rule. What is Huckel rule? We will deeply study it later. Currently, the ring has contained 4π+2π orbital electron. So Huckel rule is basically a compound which contain 4π+2π electron or carbon will obey Huckel rule. The four important criteria is that molecule is fully conjugated. So a fully conjugated means it has resonance. So now we will deeply study explanation of these four points. The first one point of our discussion is cyclic compound. So what are cyclic compound? A cyclic compound or a ring compound is a compound at least some of whose atoms are connected to form a ring. When atoms, they are connected to form a ring, the compound that formed is known as a ring compound or a cyclic compound. The ring may be vary. Ring vary in size from 3 to many 10 or even 100 of atoms. A ring usually contains 6 atoms, 7 atoms or more than atoms. It contains even thousands of atoms. So ring size may vary from one place to another place. So mostly carbocyclic compound or cyclic compound are divided into three important types. First one is carbocyclic compound, second is inorganic cyclic compound, and third one is heterocyclic compound. When we discuss about carbocyclic compound, we can define carbocyclic compound that contain carbon. The word carbo means stand for carbon, and cycle means they form a cycle. When the atoms connected to form a ring and the atoms, they consist of a carbon, then such compound form are known as carbocyclic compound. Here is a benzene, it contains all the atom which is known, all the atom known as carbon. It contains 6 carbon atom in it, so it is a carbocyclic compound. Second one is inorganic cyclic compound. Those cyclic compound which contain inorganic elements, inorganic metals, inorganic elements, they are classified as inorganic cyclic compound. So thirdly, heterocyclic compound. Those rings which contain heteroatom in it, they are usually defined as or called as heterocyclic compound. They usually contain oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur in it. So this is an example of pyridine in which nitrogen is a heteroatom. So it is a heterocyclic compound. So now we will discuss second important postulates of aromaticity, which is planar molecule or known as planarity. If all the molecular geometries around each atom in a molecule are sp2 hybridized, then the whole molecule is planar. It means for planarity, one of the most important conditions is that the carbon must be or should be sp2 hybridized. When the carbon is sp2 hybridized, it means it has a planar geometry. So it's the important postulate here discuss chair conformation of here is a cyclohexane. In cyclohexane, all the carbon are sp3 hybridized. When the carbon is sp3 hybridized, its molecular hybridization would be sp3, and it is non-planar. So when this is a chair conformation of cyclohexane, then we increase one double bond in it, so it becomes a cyclohexane. In cyclohexane, these two carbon, the hybridization of these two carbon is sp2, while the hybridization of all four carbon is sp3. So this is also a non-planar molecule. Using one double bond in a cyclohexane, this molecule is planar. Here it's chair conformation, these four carbon which are sp2 hybridized, they are planar. When we talk about these two carbon, this one and this one, these two carbon has hybridization sp3. So these hydrogen here are non-planar. So overall this molecule will be non-planar. So when we talk about by increasing one double bond in a cyclohexane, the final compound which is benzene. When we talk about benzene, it is a planar molecule. All the carbon in it are sp2 hybridized. So this is a final structure in which the compound which is formed is a planar. So this is a most important criteria for a compound to be aromatic, is that it must be or should have planar geometry. So let's move. So third important postulate for aromaticity is Huckel rule. For a cyclic compound to obey Huckel rule, its pi electron should be equal to 4n plus 2 pi electron, where n is an integer, its value would be 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. When the value of n is 0, then the number of pi electron would become 2. When the value of n is 1, the total number of pi electrons would become 6. When the value of n is 2, the total number of pi electrons would become 10. When the value of n is 3, the total number of pi electrons would become 14. So basically, when the number of pi electrons in a molecule are 2, 6, 10, 14, 18, and so on, the compound will obey Huckel rule and will be aromatic. So let's discuss some examples. Here is a cyclopropanoyl cation. It contains one pi bond. One pi bond, it means it has two pi electrons. So as we discussed earlier, for in Huckel rule, that the compound which contain either 2 pi electrons, 6 pi electrons, 10 pi electrons, they are aromatic and will obey Huckel rule. So as it contains 2 pi electrons, so it and it is cyclic, so it would be aromatic. So let's move towards second example. Here is cyclobutadiene. It contains 4 pi electron. As we know, discussed that for Huckel rule, the pi electron would be either 2, 6, or 10. Here are 4 pi electrons, so it is not non-aromatic compound. So let's move towards third example. Here is a benzene. As benzene contains 3 triple bond, it means it has 6 pi electron, so it would be aromatic. Here we will discuss here, for example, it contains 4 double bond. 4 double bond, it means it has 8 pi electrons, so it would not obey Huckel rule, so it would be non-aromatic. Here we will discuss fifth example. The molecule contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double bond. It means it contains 10 pi electrons, and 10 pi electron, a molecule containing 10 pi electron will obey Huckel rule. So it is also an aromatic compound. Let's move towards fourth postulate, which is conjugated molecule. A conjugated system is a system of connected p orbital with delocalized electrons in a molecule. A compound for conjugation is that conjugation is actually a resonance. Is a delocalization of electron. Delocalization of electron in a p orbital. Here, some example I have discussed some example. First one is a furan. Furan contains two double bond. It means it has four pi electron. But here is an oxygen, which is known as which is a heteroatom. And oxygen, you know very well, oxygen contains two lone pair. So here is a structure of furan. We see here one lone pair of oxygen is parallel to this p orbital. So one lone pair of this furan will easily take part in resonance, while other lone pair of furan is perpendicular. It will not take part in resonance. So the total number of pi electron in furan would become 6. And we discussed earlier, a compound having 6 pi electron is aromatic. So furan is a aromatic compound. So we will discuss second example, which is pyrrole. Similarly, pyrrole contains two double bond. It's mean it has 4 pi electron. Here is a nitrogen. Nitrogen contains one lone pair, and its lone pair is parallel to this p orbital. So this lone pair will easily take part in conjugation. So the total number of pi electron in pyrrole would become 6. So it is also a aromatic compound. So let's move third example, which is imidazole. In imidazole, the number of double bond is 2. So it means it has 4 pi electron. Here is there are two heteroatom, which is nitrogen. Nitrogen contains one lone pair. Here lone pair is perpendicular to this p orbital. So this lone pair will not take part in conjugation, while this lone pair is parallel to this p orbital. So p orbital of this p electron. So it will resonate easily. So that's why the imidazole is a aromatic compound, because it follow Huckel rule. It contains 6 electron. So now we will discuss about evidence of aromaticity or heat of hydrogenation. When we compare resonance energy in a molecule, is compare the heat of hydrogenation between similar compound. Actually, we will compare the heat of hydrogenation, and we will discuss about how we will determine how heat of hydrogenation provide an evidence about aromaticity. So here is a cyclohexane. Here are three compounds which are similar to one another. First one is cyclohexane. It contains one double bond. Here is 1,3 cyclohexadiene. It contains two double bond, and here is benzene. It contains three double bond. So the heat of hydrogenation of cyclohexane is 28.6 kilocalorie per mole. By increasing one double bond in it, it would become 1,3 cyclohexadiene. Its resonance, its heat of hydrogenation would become 54.9. It means exactly it would become double of cyclohexane. By increasing one double bond in 1,3 cyclohexadiene, the compound would become, which is benzene. So heat of hydrogenation would be greater than 54.9. But in experiment, the heat of hydrogenation of benzene was less than 54.9. The actual value of heat of hydrogenation of benzene was 49.3 kilocalorie per mole. The reason is that benzene is a aromatic compound, and for aromatic compound, they are stable. Heat of hydrogenation will be low. So it is an evidence of compound to provide an aromaticity. So in the end, we will discuss some importance of aromatic compound. Aromatic compound are essential in the industry. About 30 million tons of aromatic compound are produced in the world every year to produce important chemical and polymers such as polyester and nylon. Second one importance of these aromatic compound is that 3 of the 20 amino acids used to form protein are aromatic compound, and all 5 of the nucleotides that make up a DNA and RNA are all aromatic compound. You know very well our body is made up of 20 amino acids. Out of 20 amino acids, 3 amino acids are aromatic, and 5 of the nucleotides that make DNA or RNA, they are also aromatic. So dear students, it's all over. kindly like, subscribe and share this channel with your friend. Fi amanillah.